Good afternoon, and thank you so much for coming out to listen. I want to just say a few words about the next four organ pieces. First, I'm going to play a piece called Mein Weg hat Gipfel und Wellentäler by Arvo, Pärt. He's the most performed living composer. He's quite old, but he's from Estonia. And this piece is very interesting. It was written in 1989, and it was inspired by poem by the French post-war poet Edmond Chavez. And if I can find it, I'd like to read it to you. See how my French is doing. Mon chemin a eu ses grandes heures, ses douleurs. Mon chemin a ses sonnets et ses larmes de fond, son sable et son ciel. Mon chemin, où le tien? And I won't read it in German, it's not as pretty, but in English. My road had its hours of greatness, its blows, its pain. My road has its crest and its groundswell, its sand and its sky. My road, yours. So the German title is translated, My Road Has Its Crest and Its Groundswell, which I think you hear in the texture. Then I'll play a short Renaissance dance. My lady carries Dompe. No one really knows what a Dompe is. This is the only Dompe that we know of in the literature. My lady Carey is thought to refer to Mary Boleyn, the sister of Anne Boleyn, who of course was Henry VIII's second wife, but Mary was also a mistress. So it's Mary Boleyn's Dompe. I don't know what else to say. Pari is another piece by Pari, which uses his compositional technique called tintinnabulum. So one pair of voices outlines a tonic triad, in this case an E flat minor, I think. And then the other two voices move in parallel as a melody. So these two voices, the synthesis of these two voices takes on a sort of mystical quality. And then after that, I'll play another short anonymous Renaissance piece called Uppon La Mi Re. The bass does the left hand plays two overlapping versions of a melody that goes like this. This is not my idea. There's a great recording called Tintinnabulo by the Italian organist Lorenzo Ghiomi. I encourage you to check it out. He combines all of Pärt's organ music with medieval ground-based music. Okay, now I'll start playing again. Thank you. toccata is kind of a slippery genre that originated in lute and harpsichord music in the Renaissance, apparently Italian toccata to touch, and it's just set of tonality to experiment, to show off a little bit of how fast you can play, what kind of ornaments you can throw in. It's a Sweelinck, but a number of toccatas, most of them for the harpsichord, including this piece. This is really a harpsichord piece, so apologies in advance. But by the time the great French symphonists got their hands on the word toccata, it changed a lot. If you think about the famous Vierne toccata, which everyone plays at Easter, the Durafle toccata, which is probably the hardest piece there is, I think, I don't know. It's all about flashy virtuosity, using the full sound of the organ, all of the reeds and mixtures. This Vierne toccata is not played too often. It's fast, it's in B-flat minor, and it's kind of spooky and dark, which I think is appropriate for the season that we're entering. So thank you all again for coming on. I really appreciate it. Thank you to Jinsen for the invitation to come play here. Jinsen was my predecessor at St. Albans, where I grew up, and she set a very high bar for organ playing, so thank you for that, I guess. and thank you for the invitation to play on this huge and really impressive instrument. It's been a lot of fun getting to know it. So Sweelinck.